This week on Squirrel Pursuit Outdoors, William Lomax is hunting for big rutting bucks as the rut is now here. Join us in this epic hunting adventure.
So we just found the arrow here. It's absolutely filled with blood. I obviously hurt shot him, but it's like 20 yards from the bait. So the arrow just went clean through and deflected.
Let's take a look at the point of impact so we can kind of get an idea of, I'm gonna show everybody what it's like when you make a hurt shot on a deer. So that arrow deflected all the way back there. Frontal shot, it went through that deer. And this is at the point of impact. And look at the blood. It's absolutely crazy. I don't know, to be honest, if I've ever seen that kind of devastation. That quick, you can literally walk the trail. And we're gonna go recover him now. So you go ahead, William, follow the blood. I don't think you have any trouble finding it. I don't think the does are gonna want to come in here for a few days. It's craziness. I know. I see a nice big dead buck.
Oh, there we go.
buck.
He shot another one.
Yeah, he had a kicker. So he's
9-pointer. There we go. It's a nice buck.
Okay, so thanks for joining us today. We had a pretty fun morning in the woods. We actually changed gears this morning a little bit. We planned on going after a nuisance doe. We had a couple target bucks that weren't showing up the last day or day and a half or 2 days on camera, so we decided we were going to go for a doe this morning. And we had a pretty eventful morning. We ended up leaving the stand for a little bit because it was so cold, and we were warming up in the truck, and we actually saw a couple bucks chasing a pile of does in the community there where we have this nuisance property. And we just happened to get a look at this guy chasing a nice doe towards our property. We made a last minute dash for the stand, grab the crossbow and the camera, and get in the stand. And we were like, I was literally still standing when this guy appeared to the left of William. So he was putting his arrow in the crossbow, getting it ready as he stepped in. So we ended up having really good footage. And the doe that he was chasing, not sure where he ended up, where she ended up going, but he came in and was feeding on some grain and apples there that we had for some does. And he knew something was up. He looked right up in the stand at William. And normally with a bow of any sort, a frontal is not the best choice, but we were only 16 yards away. And with a crossbow, you can be pretty accurate. And he made a perfect shot. The deer only went about 30, 35 yards. And just devastation done with this muzzy broadhead that he had put in with the crossbow. So it was a quick and easy recovery like we like it, as we like it. And anyways, we got a beautiful, nice buck to celebrate this morning. So Elijah's harvested a nice buck, and now William has done, so we still have a few left to go. But we had a great morning, and this is deer number 4 down, I guess, for our family. So we have a few left to go, still lots of season left, but thanks for watching.
Guys, thanks for watching this video. It's my biggest buck yet, so I hope you've enjoyed this video so far. And if you like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching.